All right, hello, my friends, fellow entrepreneurs, and future list builders. This is Mark Gray, and I'm going to teach you today how to create a landing page on Getresponse. Now, if you don't have a Getresponse account, you can click the link below in the description. You can sign up completely for free for as long as you want, or until you get to 500 subscribers, and then you would have to start paying something. But if you do this and you get to 500 subscribers, by the time you're at 500 subscribers, you will not be bothered about paying $20 a month, because 500 subscribers will be making you a lot more than that. So what you would do is you would log into your Getresponse account, you would go to the left hand side, and you would click on landing pages. Now just let me share my screen. Now what I'm going to do, guys, is I'm going to just build a very quick quick landing page. Okay, so this one I was just playing about with, I'm going to delete it completely, so never mind that. Okay, so Getresponse has integrated AI. They're now updating a lot of things. Getresponse is more than just an autoresponder. As you're about to see, you can create landing pages, you can create websites, you can do webinars. There's all kinds of things that you can do in Getresponse just now. It's pretty awesome. It's a great platform. And like I said, you can sign up for free and stay on there for as long as you want. Collect leads until you get to 500 and then you have to start paying. So, landing pages. This is the new version. I'm just very quickly going to show you the old version of how it used to look. Now there's not a huge change. I prefer how it is now, if I'm honest. So just let me open one of these up. So this is going into the editing area. So you can see what I have written here. Now the main thing I want you to notice is here we have the I guess you would call it the builder. So these things here, like this is drag and drop text. So if I wanted some text here, which I maybe should have actually, like enter your email below, I'll do that another time. That's what you would do, okay? And you would always want to check it on mobile, which to me it seems fine on mobile. Yep, not sure why there was a little red dot. Anyway, I'm just gonna close this without saving it because it's fine for now. Okay, now where were we? Okay, there's no point in me showing you the legacy. Legacy means old, really, you know? So there's no point in me showing you that. It's very similar. So let's just go to the new landing page style, okay? Now you're gonna get, we're gonna get presented with two choices. So once we go and we click create landing page, it's gonna ask us, do you want to use an AI powered builder? Now I'm gonna tell you my personal thoughts on that. It's shit, okay? They ask you a few questions like, do you like dogs? Would you like flowers in the background? What type of people are you trying to attract? Stuff like that. And then you press go and it builds you a landing page. Now, if that worked, it would be great, but it doesn't work. It always comes out kind of stupid and funky, and you have to go in and change it anyway. So we might as well go ahead and use a ready-made template, okay? So we can go in here and you can choose from all of these different categories. I don't know what niche you're in, guys. I'm in the make money online niche, so obviously that's what I'm all about, is building a list to market to as an affiliate marketer. Simple as that, really. Okay. Now, there are, of course, different traffic sources, which I'm not going to talk about in this video, like solo ads, SEO traffic. That SEO traffic would be from your website, from YouTube. There is Google ad, Bing ad traffic. There's all different kinds of traffic. And all of those different kinds of traffic potentially need a certain type of landing page, all right, if that makes sense. So for example, if you're in the make money online niche, you're not going to probably want a landing page that has a dog on it and some things like this. You know, if you're in the make money online niche, that makes no sense to me. Maybe it does to you, but to me it doesn't. So we're going to use a ready-made template. And what I do, there is some cool stuff down here. I mean, there was one I saw earlier. This one is okay. I could work with this one here. But there was a cooler one. It was black. It was a car. Okay, let's see if I can find this one just to show you, because it was kind of cool, I thought. This one could potentially be cool. So remember, you're getting all the colors, and we can change everything in here. I mean, this is like a full page. This one might work well, but I'm not going to use that one. Yes, leave the page. Okay, right. There was one with a car, not that car, a black car that I thought was pretty. This is the one. So I'm going to just preview this so you can see it. This definitely would work in the Make Money Online niche. You know, by adding your title, name, email. Though, I'll be honest with you, I generally don't ask people for their name in my landing pages because, you know, some people are a bit lazy. Let's just say that. The thought of actually having to type their name and then type their email is just like, whoa, way too much work for me, man. So it's easier, I find, a lot of the time just to have the email. Now, just to give you an example, this is, you know, one of my websites, and this has, you know, this is information about solo ads. So you can find my website below, check out this article. It's about solo ad traffic. So obviously the traffic that you would use for this is going to be a lot different than traffic that you would be getting from a health and fitness website. Okay, it's going to be different. Of course it is. Now let's go back to Getresponse. What I like to do, though, I have to say, I do like that black car one, and I may use it at some point. What I like to do is just go to blank templates. Okay, usually 99% of the time, I'm going to click use template here. So use. 99% of the time, I find that simple works the best. Okay, it just does. So when you've opened up this is like the editor. This is where you change everything. Now, let's say you want to change the background. You click where the background is, and you can see here, we could turn the background, I don't know, red or whatever color. We're not going to do that just now. And we can, you know, change things around. If we wanted to change the title, you just click there and you can see we can change the font, we can change the size, we can change everything. Okay, we can change where all of this is. So I put together some basic information that we're going to put in. But first, what we want to do, what I would do, is if you're just looking for a landing page to collect emails, then you don't need all of this stuff at the bottom. You know, if you're looking for a web page, then great, fill all of this in. But the way I see it is, I already have websites and I direct people to those websites where there's a lot of content, a lot of information. My YouTube channel has a lot of content information. So I don't need them to be coming to, especially if I'm paying for traffic, to go to that landing page, like, you know, go to sign up. Some people will sign up, some people won't. But I don't want them to go on the landing page, scroll down, and then start reading a lot of stuff about me or about whatever is there. I want them to go, you know, get this training or put your email there, put and have a space for the email. They sign up, boom, they're on your list, and then you can follow up with them. Okay, so I'm just going to delete everything on this page. Don't need any of it. Whole sections. And to do that, if you can't see, it's a little trash can. I'll do it on this side this time so you can see, hopefully. It's quite annoying sometimes. So you see that little icon? That's like a trash can. And you can just start deleting as much as you want. Whole sections. Leave the top section though. Delete all of these sections. No need for them to be here. We don't need them. Don't want them. Bumf. Gone. Now what we do have is we have a nice clean, okay, logo. We don't need this whole section either. See the blue trash can? Gone. Logo, all of this gone. Don't need it. Right, okay, so let's put in a title. Okay, now I prepared this beforehand. So we could say, get my $200 a day online system free today. Okay, now obviously that depends on what you're going to give away. So maybe you don't have a $200 a day online system. Maybe you have a free software. Maybe you have a PDF. Maybe you have a couple of videos that you've put together. Whatever it is that gives somebody value, that's what you're aiming to give to that person, and that's what you're going to tell them. There's no sense in saying to somebody, you know, if you're on the make money line, or whatever niche you're in, actually, like if you're in the health niche, there's no point in saying, sign up to get my weight loss program free today. And then people sign up and it's actually a bodybuilding, PDF. So, you know, be honest with what you're saying. So I've just put this in, get my $200 a day online system free today. Now we go to the next part of the text. Now, of course, I can go in here and I can, it's already an H1 header, but let's say we want to change it to something else, like, doesn't really matter. This is just an example, so it could be this. I could change the font color to red. See, it looks a bit cooler. I can change the font size from 60 up to 72. I can bold that. It's already bolded, probably. Now, this next part as well, I'm going to go back to my little notepad, and I'm going to say, enter your email below to get access, and put that in. That's it, okay? I don't need it to be, you know, overly complicated for people. If they want my $200 a day online system, they're going to put their email below, okay? And we're going to deal with this name and email in a moment, all right? Because we don't want that. So I would keep this black to make it look kind of professional, though. I'm going to bold this for sure. Yeah, bold that, okay, to get access. Now, everything else is looking good. Now, just one other thing, guys. This is where this cross up the top. If you wanted to add in more text, you wanted to add in a button, a section, an image, a video. So maybe, like, for example, we want to add in an image at the bottom, okay? We would just go here and we would go to my files. What do I have? Oh, let's use this. So we could put in this image here, for example. So that would probably make more sense, though, to have this image up about here. Yeah. Okay. So get my $200 a day online system free today. Get rid of that. Now we have an image as well. Enter your email below to get instant access. Now I'm going to click this. You'll notice every time I click out, like if I click in the background, you get background options to change. If I click on the image, you get ways to change the image. Okay. If I click where the writing is, you can see that I can change the writing, the text, sorry. Now this here, as I said to you, I don't want the name. So I'm going to open up the field and I'm going to remove the name. Because like I said, for some people, it's just too much work. Even, you know, this is a great training that I'm giving away. I created it, so I think it's great. I know it's great. It's my business template. But anyway, some people are just a bit lazy. So anyway, now, just like that, we have a beautiful, let's preview it, a beautiful, to the point landing page. Now let's look at it on mobile. Oh my goodness. That looks really good on mobile, actually. This is a landing page. And like I said, for me, landing pages are about collecting people's emails and then moving them on to the next step. All right. And that's how, guys, you create. Well, one last thing. So you'd go on to continue. And you would name the template. So let's just call it test. You would choose which list you would want to put it on. So that's a whole other video, which I'll make. You would choose which list. keep this as it is. You could upload a favicon, which is basically a browser icon. So I always do that. So I'm just going to do it quickly now. In fact, you know what? I'm not even going to bother. My favicon is like this, the blue W. Okay, so you'd upload a favicon, no problem. Now you can put on a cookie consent banner. I recommend not doing that. Just don't do it, especially if you're driving, let's say, solo ad traffic, because it's just something else that can, you know, distract people, and they'll be like, oh, what's that? What's that? Because it's a banner on the bottom of the page. Leave that out of it for now, I would say. If you've made a whole web page with the opt-in form and lots of content below, then yeah, there's maybe no harm in having it. Continue. Now, this is where you would choose the name of the link that is going to be your landing page. So I'm just going to call it Coolio 200. Then you choose the prefix, the ending, and you click publish. And just like that, we've created a brand new landing page. Let's click and have a look. That looks pretty sexy, pretty cool. And that's it, guys. That's how you create a simple or more complicated, you know how to edit everything now. So you can create a simple or a more complicated, look, this has the cookie bar on it at the bottom here, which I'm gonna get rid of, but okay. Yeah, now you know how to create a cool landing page for absolute free to start building your list. If you're on YouTube, if you have a website, if you're on social media, you should be building your list, and you can start doing it completely for free with Getresponse. Okay, so click the link below, guys, sign up to Getresponse and get to it, build that list. Okay, any questions, stick them in the comments below, and I always answer any questions, so stick them in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next one. Thank you.